Yeah, sure, let me see.
If you can take a look at that, I think it's just a seed that's sort of furrowed in on itself, but it definitely looks odd to me.
So you're definitely right to pull this out. I mean, this is definitely not just a normal piece of wood. I think this is part of a seed, but based on the lack of any identifiable features, I don't think we're gonna be able to tell what it is, but it's definitely right to have it pulled out from everything else.
Yeah, so you guys wanna split them up still, or you wanna just do
this? This past summer, I went on an archeological dig with Dr. Megan Kassebaum, and we're currently in the CAM labs at the Penn Museum. This year, I've been working on the paleobotanical materials from that dig as a part of my senior thesis. I'm trying to see how plants were used at this site by this culture for both food and then also for ritual purposes. Different plants can be indicative of different time periods. So for example, we have some corn, which is really cool because it actually means that parts of our site are much later in time than we thought. They are after the transition to agriculture. CAM is the Center for the Analysis of Archaeological Materials at the museum. CAM is particularly cool because as an undergraduate, you can come in and you can do the type of research that typically only graduate students get to do. Everything is a real life application. It's all real materials from actual excavations or collections, and you get to use the tools that professionals in your field use.
You know, this material isn't fake. It isn't samples that we put together so that the students can learn something. They're working with material that is hundreds, thousands of years old, some of which has been in the museum for a long time, some of which was excavated last summer in the case of my material.
We've got our date from our sweet gum pit that's down here. So that date came back a lot earlier than I was expecting it to. We got a date of about 800 AD on that. So that's solidly in the Coles Creek period.
Are you thinking that some of the features that we found, like the pit that we sort of found over here that we decided wasn't a feature, may actually have been one? We may have just caught it late?
Yeah, it may have been a feature.
The museum is crucial to CAM because it provides a venue where students can come in without knowing anything about archaeological science and become independent undergraduate student researchers with all the benefits of having a million object collection and a number of field excavations, so potentially they can go on digs and bring back material and analyze it in the labs, and then they can put it into a complex interpretive framework. So CAM is also very interdisciplinary.
I've never done this sort of thing before, so it really is building from the ground up.
You can see the very clear features that would allow you to identify them. So they're right in the center, and both of them are facing up right now.
She's not only just teaching me how to do all this, but also encouraging me to submit this work for conferences.
So undergraduate research is incredibly important because it allows students to develop a passion for a subject instead of just sitting in the classroom and learning the steps they have to go through to do something. They actually learn to be passionate about the questions that are being asked. And I think that's essential to undergraduate education.
The research that I do here is definitely something that I hope to continue on doing in graduate school. And this has given me an opportunity to really explore something specifically and to realize, oh, maybe there's enough questions here that I would be perfectly happy going on and answering these for a while.